The hand anatomy and nerve supply is a little complex, and we'll just review some of the key takeaways for consideration when examining the hand. The important nerves for consideration include the radial nerve, which you can think of as the reaching nerve, the median nerve, which you can think of as the flexor nerve, and the ulnar nerve. And we will review each of these individually. The radial nerve can be considered as the reaching nerve and supplies the dorsal 3.5 fingers, and for motor supply, it aids in the extension of the wrists and fingers. So it allows for wrist extension. If a patient has a radial nerve palsy, they will present with a wrist drop. The median nerve can be thought of as a flexor nerve and supplies the palmar radial 3.5 fingers and the distal fingers dorsally. And for motor supply, it supplies ulnar-sided wrist flexion, MCPJ and PIBJ flexion, and the second and third DIPJ. Therefore, the normal movements supplied by the median nerve includes radial-sided wrist flexion, thumb flexion, second and third MCPJ flexion, and PIBJ extension, MCPJs and PIBJs flexion, and second and third DIPJ flexion. Issues with these movements will result in the inability to flex the first, second, and third digit when asked to make a fist, which will present as shown here. This is known as the hand of benediction. It is known as such as it is a common hand posture in which priests will have when saying a blessing. You can also ask the patient to do the OK sign. This is a normal OK sign when there is flexion at the thumb, IPJ, and the second DIPJ. This is an abnormal OK sign when the patient is unable to flex the thumb, IPJ, and the second DIPJ. The ulnar nerve supplies sensation to the ulnar 1.5 of the fingers, and for motor supply, it supplies thumb adduction, finger adduction and abduction, ulnar-sided wrist flexion, and fourth and fifth DIPJ flexion. Normal movements supplied by the ulnar nerve include ulnar-sided wrist flexion, fourth and fifth MCPJ flexion and PIPJ extension, and fourth and fifth DIPJ flexion. Injury to the ulnar nerve may present with an ulnar claw, related to issues of movements here. When asked to extend their fingers, instead, there's hyperextension of the MCPJ and flexion of the PIPJ of the fourth and fifth digit. There may also be a Froment sign when the thumb adductors are weak due to ulnar nerve palsy. Patients will attempt to hold a piece of paper by flexing the IPJ of the thumb, which is supplied by the median nerve.